We have a really proactive chair, Dr. Eric Triplett. He just immediately started thinking about the future and how can we protect best our students, faculty, and staff. Our lecture classes are online already, so that's not a big problem. But for the labs, obviously, that was a big of his concern. And he sent me an email and said, do you think you can do it? And I said, absolutely, we can make it work. I've been putting my thinking hat on over the weekend, what can we do? And for example, one of our first exercises is, you know, we do a pipetting exercise where we use micropipettes. And we do a dilution series and evaluate the pipetting skills. But what you can do, you could, for example, send the pipettes home. And then you can use an app with the phone and with the online modules, we can all put our data together and then still have a classroom atmosphere, although we do some of the things at home. Again, hands-on skills are important, but I think they're very creative ways, especially with the technology we have on hand, where we can do a lot of fun things at home. I ask students, do you have any advice what we can do? You know, what's working for you? Do you have any ideas? Have you come across any simulations or any programs that can help us to make your learning better? And I get emails back as well and say, yeah, you know, I've seen this, or I've seen, you know, I've learned about that before, and we could use that in this environment. You know, the stress, the additional stress, I mean, students are stressed enough without the situation. The additional stress can really have also a mental health burden, and I think we all need to be sensitive to that as well. And you know, as faculty, we don't need to pretend we're perfect. You know, we're trying our best. We want to have high quality education continuously for the students, but we work with the system and with everything we have to make it work.